Yeah. I don't know what to say. So, it's been an absolutely horrible, horrible weekend for Australia, with multiple stabbings throughout the weekend. Breaking news, a church stabbing in Sydney, Southwest, declared a terrorist attack. On this guy here. This guy's well known on social media. Can't remember his name though. I've seen him on YouTube every now and then. It's just been... it's been tough to grasp. You know, you would think that all the stabbing and all the violence like this would stop, but... so this is who he is.
A prominent Sydney bishop is among four people who were stabbed at a church in Wakeley in the city's west last night. A 15-year-old boy is in police custody this morning. The attack, which was live streamed, prompted angry scenes outside the church where several police officers were injured. And a warning, the following story contains vision that viewers may find distressing.
Bishop Marmarie Emmanuel was delivering Mass on Monday night when a 15-year-old boy in a black hoodie lunged towards him, stabbing him multiple times. The attack occurred at the Christ the Good Shepherd Church in Wakeley just after 7 p.m. Those in attendance rushed in to assist, separating the bishop from the alleged assailant. The Mass was also being live-streamed. The bishop was taken to Liverpool Hospital. Another clergyman was stabbed, along with two others. They all have non-life-threatening injuries. But the situation quickly escalated.
Oh my God.
A large crowd gathering outside the church.
The crowd continued to build an emotional response to what took place in the church. A public order incident developed, requiring police from all regions across Sydney, upwards of 100 police and more than 30 police vehicles attended, with special resources and police poll air attending.
Bricks were hurled at police vehicles as the crowd grew angry. Authorities seen attempting to get the situation under control. Several police officers were injured.
There's two police that are being conveyed to hospital with injuries. Their injuries are quite serious, but again, I'm reading reports now that there's multiple police have been hit with bottles and bricks and other items across the night.
The incident comes just 2 days after the mass stabbing at Bondi, where six people were killed. The alleged assailant is in police custody with serious injuries to his hand. He asked to see his parents. Christy Lloyd, Sky News.
I'm just fucking pissed right now. Like, what has this guy done? I should turn up my light. Like, what has this guy done? You know, I get people have different views of opinion. But for fuck's sakes, you're gonna have a crack at someone, you're gonna try and murder someone? It's just been real tough. Like we'll pray for him. Marmari, you know, if you're listening to this, may God put his healing hand on you and you come back stronger than ever. Okay. So there's been this video has been popping up very, very... There's a couple of videos here. We'll watch of him.
He has showed me I fear nothing. I'm not here for people to love me. I'm here for Jesus to be pleased with this vessel that he uses for his glory and his glory only. He has showed me heaven and hell. And let me say this with love and humility. When you go to heaven, I can assure you, not because I'm a Christian, not because I'm a bishop, not because I believe in Jesus Christ, but I can assure you, in heaven, you, Muhammad will not greet you, Buddha will not greet you, Krishna will not greet you, because they will not. It will be only one who is the way, the truth, and the life. It will be Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who died Amen. For you and me. I'm inviting you to accept Jesus as Lord and Savior, because there is no other way. If we don't have him, we are doomed forever, for in him eternal life lies.
Amen.
Sitting there at the right hand of the Father over 2,000 years ago, and he will come back again to judge the dead and the living, because he's not just a prophet, for he is God revealed in the flesh. This is the Jesus I talk about. That's why I fear no one. I fear nothing. I'm not here for people to love me. I'm here for Jesus to be pleased with this vessel that he uses for his glory and his glory only. He has...
Come back stronger than ever. Yeah, he will. He will. John 16:33, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Amen. Whether I live or die, Jesus is the love of my life. Amen. So apparently, the guy that stabbed him is Islamic. Yeah, wow. I don't know. It's all breaking news. We'll wait for the news to escalate. Australia has some major issues with social cohesion right now. The attack on the bishop seems to have been the work of 15 Islamic fundamentalists. Subsequent sectarian conflict has broken out into the streets of Sydney, southwest Sydney. Really, like, you're going to talk about a man that they got stabbed, about him being an anti-vax and him being a skeptic. Like, mass slavery. It was mass slavery. Like, we were being held like hostage on post. Oh, for fuck's sake.
say. Now let me tell you this. I pray that Donald Trump is in the White House this year. I pray that Donald Trump is in the White House this year. Is he perfect? No. Well, who is perfect? No one. So, does he make mistakes? Yes, like all of us do. But America has Trump as the only option. If Trump is not in the White House this year, you can kiss America goodbye. People agree, disagree, that's their choice. But this is not from me. This is from the Lord.
Amen.
America will go very soon. And
yep.
It's not about Trump. It's about the Lord. We need to pray. Now please pay attention. We need to pray for America not to fall as yet. Because if America falls, Christians and so many others will be persecuted beyond measures. Beyond measures. A 3-year-old girl came out of one of the houses. She stood in front of the door. I'm looking from inside the bus onto that girl. I waved at her. She waved at me. I said, good. I said, bus driver, open the door. He said, Bishop, it was scary enough to come in here. You want me to let you out of the bus? He said, you know what will happen once you leave this bus? This whole town will come running at you. I will close the door and I'll drive away. I can't help you. I said, open the door. He said, I'm not taking the risk. I said, we pay you. You do as I say. Open the door. I want to say hello to this little girl. Palestinian, Muslim girl, my sweetheart. Yeah? I don't care. This is a little angel. Stop killing little angels. He opened the door eventually. I came out of the bus. I said, close the door. He closed it. I called her. I said, I spoke in Arabic. I said, Habibi Ta'on, come here, my darling, my sweetheart. She came. I had an Australian flag, just a piece of stick and a little plastic flag on top of it. I didn't have anything. I gave her that. It was as if I gave her the whole world. The first time ever someone giving a gift to this little angel. She was overwhelmed with joy. She didn't know what to do. She started jumping. And then her grandma came out. And as I was talking to them, I turned around. The whole town is running at me. In the hundreds, men. And the way they were running, I said, Allahu Akbar. I said, my name is Osama bin Laden. I'll blow you up. The bus driver, Bishop, get in the bus. I said, go, brother. I'm not moving. Let them chop me. What are they going to do? I don't care. I'm staying here. They came in a blink of an eye running. I'm literally running fast like a gazelle. They surrounded the whole bus and me in the hundreds. And they started saying, nobody asks about us. Nobody cares about us. Nobody knows how we live. We are struggling here. Please, please help us. I went into the bus, collected some money, gave whatever we could give. And then they started saying, God bless you. God be with you. Thank you so much for coming and visiting us. Please tell everyone the way we live in here. We are starving to death.
And this guy got stabbed. Yeah. you know, the Bible clearly states not to judge, but it's just so hard. But you got to keep pushing. So this platform, Robot News, I've heard of this.
Stabbing?
Yeah.
And I saw him, I ran and grabbed him from behind and just pushed him down. Look. Oh, that's all his blood.
Wow.
Motherfucker. He kept saying, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar.
Yeah, extremist. That's it. Yeah, he was an extremist. I'm gonna put out a tweet. I wanna get the name right, because it's the spelling in my head's not quite there. I want to get the victims of the Bondi stabbing correct. I'm just going to say it out here. Lord, pray for Bishop Marmari. Pray for the Bondi Junction Bowl stabbing victims. I pray that our beautiful country of Shire finds peace after this horrible weekend. Lord, help us find the strength to recover from this weekend and last couple of days. Lord, guide us. You're our only hope. Lord, remind everybody here of the strength that you can give us. Amen. Double checking something. Why is JK Rowling trending? Why? I got no idea how this escalated. So, I got no idea. Now, what's this on about the CEO?
I'm not interested.
So the numbers we always look at are our return on funds.
I'm not interested or asking you about the numbers you look at. I'm asking you about the numbers that the committee is interested in, and that at the moment is return on equity. I'm happy to talk about those other numbers later. I'm asking you for your return on equity in that financial year where you made $1.7 billion in profit.
Senator, that would be available in the annual report. I can only talk to the numbers that we focus on and we measure our business on.
That you focus on?
Which is the commonly agreed, which is return on investment. How much money do you put in and what return do you get out?
Return on equity is generally what investors look at to determine the profitability of a business, Mr. Banducci. I'm asking you about return on equity. I'm going to put it to you that the average size of your equity base in that financial year was north of $6.6 billion, which makes your return on equity in the last financial year about 26%. Would you agree with that?
Senator, the measure we use is return on investment.
Mr. Banducci, please, I'm not interested in your spin here today. I'm interested in you responding to the questions that you are being asked, and I'm asking you about return on equity, please.
Senator, with due respect, we look at return on investment, which is the key measure for our business.
Are you struggling with the ordinary English language meaning of the words that I'm using in my questions?
I'm focusing on corporate finance, Senator, and that's what we use.
I am asking you about return on equity. I'm not asking you about any other accepted measure of profitability. I'm asking you about this particular accepted measure.
This guy would have my respect if he answered the question.
Return on equity. Would you dispute that your ROE in the last financial year?
Unbelievable. This guy kept going on during the tweets. Yeah. How many people have stopped going to Woolies and Coles have gone to Aldi instead? Like, Aldi is just the way to go these days. It's Pauline Hanson coming in. All right, let's so this is what Pauline Hanson said. I'm gonna make sure you can read that. Islamic fundamentalism has no place in Australia, and those who would bring it here must be prevented from entering the country. One Nation leader Senator Pauline Hanson, responding to yesterday's terrorist attack on a Christian bishop at a church in Wakeley, said Labor was ignoring the danger of importing Islamics to shore up votes in Western Sydney seats held by federal ministers. What we're seeing in countries like UK, France and the Netherlands, which have allowed huge numbers of immigrants from countries where this appalling ideology is rife, is that too many of these people do not adopt the laws and values of the countries they settle in. We see that a lot in the US as well, illegal immigrants not following the law. Instead, they demand that fundamentalism is simply accepted and adopted in their new countries, and they employ violence or radicalize young people into violence and perverse attempts to achieve this end or attack those who oppose them. Islamic ideology, which seeks to impose fundamentalist Islam across the world, is completely incompatible with Australian values of freedom, democracy, and religious tolerance. People who have immersed this in this ideology in their countries of origin despise our values. The result is terrorist attacks in Australia, as we saw in Wakeley last night. Extremist Islamic preachers in Australia calling for yihad and death, getting away with it. And the intimidation and violence we've seen directed at Jewish Australians since the 7th of October. I'm just going to, in my head, read this. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Candace Owens, you're onto it. Yeah, Christians are never attacked. Yeah.
Life expectancy, because actually life expectancy. So if you're Joe Biden standing for re-election at the age of 81, the obvious question is, what exactly are you going to run on? You're not going to run on the state of the economy. You're not going to run on the state of the world, which is increasingly chaotic. You're not going to run on lengthening life expectancy, because actually life expectancy is declining in the United States under his watch. So what are you going to run on? Well, you're going to run against. And the main thing Biden is going to run against is Christianity, running against Christianity. He's already put people in prison for praying, so it's not a stretch. But of course, you're not going to say, I'm running against Christianity, the world's largest religion. You're going to say, I'm running against something called Christian nationalism, which was a way of making traditional Christianity seem like a threat to the country rather than the principle upon which it was founded. So that is their plan. They're going to run against something called Christian nationalism. And in this, they have the full cooperation of Hollywood and the media outlets, which are whipping up the population to a frenzy over this threat called Christian nationalism. Well, most of us, even those of us who pay some attention, aren't really sure what Christian nationalism is. Is it a product of what it sounds like, which is some branding meeting in the basement of the DNC designed to make Christians seem really scary if they believe in God? Maybe. We decided we would ask the person most closely identified with that phrase, Christian nationalism. He's one of the rare American Christian pastors who is willing to engage on questions of culture and politics. And for that, he has taken a lot of grief, but we are honored to have him. His name is Doug Wilson. He's the pastor at Christ Church in Moscow, Idaho. He's the author of several books, including a book called Mere Christendom, The Case for Bringing Christianity Back into Modern Culture. And Pastor Wilson joins us now. Pastor, thank you very much.
Well, it's an honor to be here. Thank you.
Thank you. So I was not opposed. I'm sincerely confused by the phrase Christian nationalism, which seems like an attack on Christianity to me.
Mm-hmm.
What is it, to the extent you understand it, and are you a Christian nationalist?
So I'm willing to be a Christian nationalist because
okay.
because I prefer that phrase to the phrase I usually get called. So
I do this thing all the time, by the way. I just don't continue watching videos. That's just me. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your gracious spirit lead me forward on a firm foot.
Yes!
Why is this up for me, bro? How'd I do Mario anymore?
Dad.
Alrighty, let's just cheer things up a little bit. Let's just go through my shorts, shall we?
We're gonna be circulated on the internet that there's going to be a live action iteration of this created by Disney, where the famous Rapunzel is going to be played by none other than Indian actress Ivantika. But of course, as this fan casting was circulating, people had to come to bat for Ivantika and defend her casting in this role. People made threads about how it makes sense for an Indian actress to portray Rapunzel. They're saying that Indian women are known for having long hair, or creating beautiful colorful paintings like Rapunzel does in the film, or putting flowers in their hair, or that India even has a festival of lights, which we see in the lantern release in Tangled towards the end of the film. And all of this is fine. I understand why people are defending this fan cast, especially if you have different views when it comes to representation in films. But Rapunzel's features and characteristics are referenced several times throughout all of the classic iterations that we have of this story. And quite frankly, she's not an Indian woman. Others are asking the question, if you think it's right to switch characters like Ariel and Rapunzel, why not switch characters like Jasmine or Tiana, who are people of color? We're gonna be talking about the drama surrounding
10 things I bought for my kitchen.
These are reusable straws that come apart when it's time to clean them.
And once you're done, you connect it back together.
This is a fruit and vegetable washer that gets rid of pesticides on produce.
It's battery operated, so all you have to do is put it in water.
This is a drink cleaning brush that attaches to any type of sink,
and its design makes it easy to clean any type of bottle.
This is an eggplant sauce bottle.
All you have to do is put your favorite sauce inside, and then it comes out easily.
These are food huggers, which are designed to keep fruits and vegetables fresh.
It works on soda cans and even bananas.
This gadget secures wine glasses when you put them in the dishwasher so they don't move around or break.
This is a sliding tray, which makes it easy to move your appliances on the counter.
This gadget is the best and safest way to clean knives, and it also works for other utensils.
This is a pickle fork, which keeps your hands dry when you're getting pickles out of the jar.
This is an egg storage container for your fridge.
Once you take an egg, another takes its place.
This is a talk box.
No. Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
I don't.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
I'm trying to eat.
Do you follow Jesus?
I do not, brother.
Do you follow Jesus? Do you follow Jesus?
I'm sorry, man.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
No, we're good.
Do you follow Jesus?
I'm not religious.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
How about you?
No. I'm not interested.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
In my own way.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
Do you follow Jesus?
I'm Catholic, yes.
Do you follow Jesus?
No, thank you.
Do you follow Jesus? Do you follow Jesus?
No, thank you.
Do you follow Jesus?
No, thank you.
Do you follow Jesus?
No.
How about you? Do you follow Jesus?
Not as much as I used to, but I'm good.
Do you follow Jesus?
I do.
What's your testimony?
I was listening to the radio. I heard some preacher say, do you want to accept Jesus? I knelt down and I just started bawling. I believe Jesus died for my sins and wanted a relationship with me. Today is the day. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Accept him today. Don't wait.
Do you follow
Jesus?
Elections have consequences.
Let me show you Biden's in America for those that still want to vote for this. Are you ready? Because I'm in the grocery store right now. So let's go. I'm sorry. $6.19 for Lay's potato chips?
That's a lot.
Come
let's go
on.
To ground beef. You ready?
That's cheaper than us. And the U.S. currency is smaller than the Australian currency. Our chips are like $3-4. Oh my goodness.
Ground beef before the discount is $12.58. Now it's $10.02. Let's go to some steak. You ready? Okay? All of you that want to continue voting for this bag. Okay? Let's look at the steak. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
$39 for two steaks.
$18 for a freaking steak. Oh,
I paid YouTubers $1,000.
And over here it's $15. Still high, but...
So I was on Cameo looking to get a personalized video.
When was the last time you saw a resurrection of anybody?
Last time I saw,
you
I
saw
never
a,
have
d-
seen
dead,
a resurrection.
Exactly. Have you ever seen any kind of a phenomenon like that before?
No.
I mean, so how can you believe something like that?
Because
yes,
first of all,
I mean,
the evidence is that a supernatural God exists, and because a supernatural God exists, he is totally capable of performing a miracle.
So you've seen God, basically?
No, I've seen evidence that God exists.
Like what?
Order and design of the cosmos. Light coming from light, not from non-light. Moral absolutes pointing us to the fact that there's more to reality than matter and energy. Free will.
Can you prove that we even exist?
Sir, I can't even prove we're having this conversation.
Exactly. Exactly. When you start talking about all these different things, and what you're basically talking about is whose rhetoric is stronger, and then you would follow that.
No, sir. Right here. I can't prove to you he's sitting here. It is not an issue of rhetoric, whether I stop my hand right there. It is an issue of evidence. Evidence is he is sitting here. That's why I don't keep swinging through his handsome face. Has nothing to do with rhetoric. Has to do with evidence that the guy's sitting here. I base my life on evidence.
When was the last time you saw a resurrection of anybody?
China Fix Everything Part 11. You like shopping on Temu? This man did. His charger is now married to the outlet. And does that chip spy on you? Xiaomi's new EV claims they have an anti-hand crushing feature, so people tested it themselves, and it turns out to be a lie. And not just one EV makers, all of them seem to have this problem.
Do you recognize this painting? Well, what if I were to tell you that we've been looking at it wrong this entire time? It's called the scream, and most people assume that's because the figure is screaming, but that's not actually the case. The artist painted it after seeing a deep red sunset that overwhelmed him so much he had a panic attack. You see, this figure isn't screaming. He's covering his ears to block the scream. Do you recognize this paint?
There's no going back.
I
think we still do live in a patriarchy. I think men wield probably more power than we ever did. It's just in a very perverted way. Men, you know, wield the power to have casual hookups. Women statistically tend to not prefer casual hookups. Mm-hmm. Men tend to like them quite a lot more. And women prefer a longer lasting relationship.
That's what I would agree with. I think marriage, that's what I meant by cultural currency. I think men have the monopoly on like the cultural zeitgeist.
Totally.
And then women move in lockstep to like men's desires and the male gaze. So I would agree with that.
Yeah, yeah.
In terms of politically, I don't know if I would agree as much, but I agree with that definition.
Totally, totally. The irony though is that all of that sexual revolution came about because of feminism. It didn't really give women, I think, what they thought they were going to get. I think if anything, it gave men more power. I remember thinking about this many years ago when I was in college and the hookup culture was really burgeoning. Mm-hmm. I thought, is this the greatest trick that men ever played on women? Mm-hmm. That these women who call themselves feminists think that they're going to be empowered by letting men just use them whenever they want and then cast them aside.
She walks me into the doctor's office. I sit down, doctor walks in, and we spoke for an hour. In a nutshell, what he says is that he wants to take my stomach, which in his opinion is the size of an NFL football, and he wants to cut it and make it the size of a hard-boiled egg. Therefore, you only eat this much and you lose weight with time. Problem with gastric bypass is that if you don't stick to their program religiously, not only will you not lose weight, you will gain weight and you'll have a series of complications. And then he asks, do you travel a lot? I'm like, I'm on the road 46 weeks out of the year. He goes, this is not gonna work for you. I'm like, I agree. I like two eggs. I said, well, what should I do? He goes, I don't know, but this isn't gonna work. So I left the office. I was bummed out, you guys. I get in my car. I was so depressed because I'm like, someone told me I got 2 years to live. Surgery is my last hope. And so I started crying. I was sad. I was in the car. I'm crying. I'm like, what the hell am I gonna do? And the only thing that could cheer me up was a drive-thru.
I'm breaking up with you. I've been cheating on you with your friend.
Could this Home Goods painting be making your child?
Here are three facts you probably want to know. Number three, have you ever used a post-it note and it ended up looking like this? Well, if you just peel it across at the top, they actually lay perfectly flat. Number two, did you know the dots on a dice are called pips? Apparently, pips are small but easily countable items. The symbols on playing cards and the dots on dominoes are also called pips. Number one, you know these packets you find in everything you buy? Well, most people think they're poisonous because of the warnings, but they're actually just small, harmless chunks of silica that absorb water to keep products dry. Here are three facts you-
So my question is, even if you have like two types of education, if your parents are teaching you, you know, the basic needs for, you know, for life, and you're getting an education for school, you know, is that really a scam or?
Well, it depends. What are you studying? I'm curious.
Political science.
Okay. What are you going to do when you graduate?
Go to law school.
Okay, that's a good answer. So for you, it might not end up being a scam. The institution itself is a scam. You can navigate something that is a scam and turn it into a positive. I've always argued that.
So my question is,
when the entire audience were booing Candace Owens and not letting her speak, Killer Mike decided to step in and he delivered.
The biggest issue facing Black America is father absence. This is why I do not mess with feminism at all. This breakdown and mocking masculinity, making it seem like there's something wrong to be a man, all of this contributes to the breakdown of family.
This is on your behalf. At a certain point, we can't be assholes. At a certain point, these are Black men and women, and in particular, these are Black women. It doesn't matter how you feel about her personally. Everything she has just said, Louis Farrakhan said for the last 25 years. You cannot take the truth and be mad at who tells it to you.
So then he asks, what's going to happen? I go, well, I'm going to go upstairs, take a shower, and probably go to bed. No, what's going to happen if I don't get my phone back? I go, that's a good question, Frankie. I don't know. You're not going to get me a new one? No, dude, I already got you a phone. It was your responsibility to take care of that phone. It's not fair. I go, life's not fair, Frankie, okay? But things happen. You should get me a phone. Dude, seriously?
Women's rights.
Oh, I love this video.
We can't define what a woman is, but also men can be women.
Yeah.
And no uterus, no opinion, but also men can get pregnant.
Yeah.
Men are oppressing us, but also it's okay if biological men take over our spaces and our sports. Women are so over-sexualized in this culture, but it's empowering if women are the ones sexualizing themselves. Are you guys quite done yet? Like, are you okay?
That just about sums it up.
This is my friend Brianna Robinson. You should absolutely go follow.
I absolutely love this.
Thank you.
love it because it really doesn't take much to be intentional about your relationships, especially being a dad. I'm receiving this personally, but if more dads just took a little bit of time investing in their kids, I think we'd fix a lot of problems in this culture. I absolutely love this.
This Snow White press tour has got to be the worst marketing I've ever seen for a movie. I mean, the new Snow White actress is literally walking around interview to interview just bashing Snow White.
The original cartoon came out in 1937, and very evidently so. There is a big focus on her love story with a guy who literally stalks her. Weird. So we didn't do that.
Move on.
We lost the idea of a man leading the house, and that's going to fuck us up completely.
Trump is too smart to be dealing with these people.
Illegal immigrants are causing tremendous crime.
Immigrants commit less crime than U.S.-born citizens.
Illegal immigrants. I'm talking about illegal immigrants. I'm not talking about immigrants. I'm talking about illegal immigrants. Mm-hmm. I'm an immigrant. You're an immigrant. We're all immigrants.
The Pew Research says that there are, for immigrants on the whole,
Come on, try getting it out. Try getting it out.
I'll get it out.
I mean, I don't know if you're going to put this on television, but you don't even know what you're talking about. Try getting it out. Go ahead. You're a very naive person.
Trump is too smart.
When this baby started crawling to
Amazon home,
I love this channel. Dylan and Innocent is awesome.
Was open, their dog noticed this was unsafe and immediately got up and tapped her to go the other way. He then walked over to the front door and laid down the guarding. After she continued to crawl towards the front, the dog blocked her again and decided to start pushing her the other direction. An incredibly smart dog doing everything to make sure.
Oh my goodness!
When this baby,
that's
Amazon
a good
home favorite. This is a cuddle pillow which has a built-in hole where you can put your arm.
You can also take off the cover so you can wash it easily.
This is a remote control finder with 6 receivers. You can put it on anything that you don't want to lose, and then you'll be able to find it with a push of a button. It works great for finding your house keys, your TV remote, and even your favorite food. This is a busy flag that you put on the back of your laptop. You're able to set the color and make it green if you're available, or red if you're busy. And it even has a police mode. This is a stapler that doesn't need any staples. It works by making a flap that combines the two papers. At first, I thought it wasn't gonna work, but it holds up surprisingly well. This is a bag cleaning ball, and I wanted to test it out using one of my girlfriend's purses. All you have to do is put the ball in it and shake it a few times. After about 30 seconds, I opened the bag, and the ball collected almost all of the dirt. Amazon home favorite. This is a cuddle pillow.
Whoopi Goldberg is accused.
Sorry, just gotta do something quickly.
Republicans of trying to reinstate slavery in America.
Take a look at the things that they're rolling back. Mm. Remember I said ages ago, you know, they, in their minds, they want to bring slavery back. One of the good things about the Supreme Court is you can fight to make sure you make stuff better. Mm-hmm. You don't generally fight to make stuff worse.
or to roll back.
And to me, if you're okay rolling that back, when things were not even a state, when we had no say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So how's that gonna roll? How's that gonna roll? What's the next thing? Because, you know, on this, with all of this comes birth control.
Right.
With all of this That's comes next. Everything that you need as a woman to have had put in place to make sure.
A lot of people say to me, Cliff, it doesn't matter what I believe. I just want to be a good person. That's a religion. That's saying the way to heaven is by being a good person. No, false. Jesus bled and died on the cross to pay the penalty for our wrongdoing, to forgive us and to give us a gift, forgiveness and eternal life. So the person who says, it doesn't matter what you believe, just be a good person, they're
gaming has proven health benefits.
Say what?
But we only
I've seen this video.
Here are some surprising benefits of being a gamer in reasonable doses. Playing shooters can improve a person's ability to think about objects in three dimensions, just as well as academic classes designed to improve the same skill. Gaming actually develops the physical brain. There's increased white and gray matter integrity in both the visual and motor pathways, thereby improving reaction time and coordination. The Columbia School of Public Health found gaming actually improved peer relationships and supported healthy social skills. Those who reported playing strategy games such as RPGs had improvements in problem solving and academic performance the following year. Simple, accessible games that can be played quickly can improve players' moods, promote relaxation, and even ward off anxiety. Video games aren't going anywhere, and they certainly have downsides, especially if you overdo it. So instead of villainizing, let's keep investigating how to make them work for us. Gaming has proven health benefits.
Say what?
There's a girl who's gone viral for expressing her frustration that her boyfriend just doesn't get her.
Whenever I talk about something to my boyfriend.
So you were comparing the LGBTQ community to animals that are not humans.
No, I was comparing the argument of transgender people to be a thing they are not to people who also claim to be a thing they are not. That was the argument.
So I wanted to ask, our mind thinks differently than other animals. Shouldn't we have the ability to go to a higher level where we are able to overcome the societal constructs that have been created?
So, I don't think biology is a social construct, and I think the greatest way of finding unhappiness in your life is to go to direct war with biological reality. If you walk off the 99th store of a building saying we've developed in our society to the point where really we should be able to transcend the laws of physics, about halfway down you're going to realize this is a very bad idea. And if you do the same thing with biology, saying that biology no longer matters because we in our Cartesian minds are able to have ourselves soar above the realities of biology, this is a very bad way of living your life that's going to end with an enormous amount of misery.
So you were comparing the LGBTQ community to...
You and I need to learn to talk with God, not just at God. To talk with God is to have a conversation with him on a daily basis, in your heart, in your worship, in everything that takes place. To talk at God is to only come to God when you need a prayer request answered. You and I need to learn to talk with God, not just at God. To talk with God is to have a conversation with him on a daily basis, in your heart, in your worship, in everything that takes place. To talk at God is to only come to God when you need a prayer request answered. You and I.
Sir, do you know why I pulled you over today?
He said one day you leave this world. Why isn't Hollywood?
I played the first video game ever created. So many people believe that either Pong, created by Atari in 1972, or Tennis for Two, created by William Higginbottom in 1958, was the first of
white privilege.
Right.
Think about it. Whose flesh tone is this?
Oh my god.
I have brown band-aids in my classroom. I had to special order.
It's a fucking band-aid. Come on. Oh my gosh.
Okay, everybody, we'll begin with presentation.
Oh, I'll tell you all.
Do you know why I pulled you over?
No idea. I don't think I was speeding.
It's that Trump 2024 sticker in New York City. That's a felony now.
New York City? This looks like Texas.
Ah, don't ruin the video now. But here in New York City, it is both illegal to be Trump or to support Trump.
I'm not surprised. What do you think?
Even
we spent a lot of time traveling.
Self-denial is an attack.
I'm gonna leave. Hi.